What do we do now?
We'll figure it out.
But I don't think Marlene's gonna go.
Wait.
So with that, ladies and gentlemen, with sutures in hand and en route back to Joel, my name is Allison Cruz, and welcome to the penultimate chapter of The Last of Us Left Behind, where ahead we have probably the most difficult combat that this DLC actually has to offer, but it's pretty hilarious because not only are we going to be pitted against infected, but human characters as well, and getting them to fight each other is absolutely hilarious. But before we do, we're gonna head in here for a bit of a sad sight. It's yet another member of the crew. Now, you'll come to notice that this photo that they were holding is the last thing they saw before, well, they died. And unfortunately, it's a tough look to the coolest captain around. So, Captain Reagan is the one that put Larry and Ellis out of their misery. We still don't know what happened to Sean, or do we? And it's pretty tragic. The first time I saw this photo, I actually thought that Ellis's arm was already amputated because it doesn't look like it's there, but then because of the way that he's holding like a jacket over his shoulder, I was like, oh, that would make sense. But yeah, Captain Reagan lies before us, and she's had quite a few terrible decisions to make. It's sad. Now, over here to Octopus Records, we're gonna be in for a bit of a surprise. So, let's head forward, see what we got.
Oh, shit.
What the hell?
Relax.
What the hell are we doing here? Who gives a fuck about that old man and a little girl?
The sooner we find them, the sooner we get out of here. Make sure this area's clear.
I'm going this way. Go check around back.
Alright, we got three enemies, and luckily for us, they are absolutely loaded to the brim. We only had the one shot there, but that's alright. Looks like these two did split up, which is really nice for us. And if this guy on the left would like to come over here to this side of the record store, that would be great, because the other guy has the world's best vision. And it's fine if he sees us, to be honest, but there we go. Nice. I don't know why he had an arrow on him, but I will take it. Alright. So, moving through this area, tons of pickups just everywhere. And we are going to be finding just so many things that are going to help us. Not enough to really make that much of a difference, but so long as we get to make a bomb, I think we'll be fine. Now, this guy we can probably take out just fine with a brick. Because she's a brick. And we'll go and toss it. Sprint and dead. And Ellie, holy smokes. Okay.
All right. I'm coming to get you, Joel. These guys want to fight. I'll fucking give them one.
Hell yeah, Ellie. Nice.
I'm going to get to him, stitch him up, and then I'm going to get the hell out of here.
You know, maybe there wasn't as much stuff here as I thought there would be. There's a brick, but I'm purposefully going to take a bottle with us because there's actually something that you can do that's pretty hilarious. So I'll take that. And what's interesting about this particular confrontation is that enemies will generally drop a lot of ammo. And it looks like they did not really do anything here. And it's because I had 7 bullets that they probably didn't, but this guy will usually have somewhere close to 13 or 14 on him. I just came in here with too many bullets, so that's a bit of a shame, and I think that's it. So let's get the hell out of here, because this detour we're going to take is not a fun one, and it is going to take a while to get back to where we were. On top of that, we are also going to follow this trail of blood. Lovely. It looks fresh, but something tells me It is not. But, you know, what bad ever came out of, you know, following a trail of blood this thick?
Which way?
But here we have the corpse of Ellis, and you can tell because of his missing arm. So we have a really tragic duct recorder, but I'm not going to sit down here and listen to it. It's too sad, man. So we're going to continue onwards, and we're going to find another opportunity to have a little bit of fun, because we have some infected over here.
Fuck these guys.
And some very unsuspecting humans. Now, a funny thing that you can do is throw a bottle at this guy, and no one will react to him at all if you throw anything at him. It's hilarious. But now we have the world's bravest, like, hunters, like, just literally sprinting at him. Look at, he just, Jesus. Use your gun, dude. Later days, nerd. Good God, look at. All right, well, as long as they take out one of them, I think we can finish off the clickers just fine. He's gonna die. The incompetence of these guys is surreal. Look at that. Yeah, no wonder why that guy had no ammo on him. Oh, shit. Shit, man. I am... Oh, God. This is not what I wanted to have happen. Can't backtrack. This is terrible. I'm out. Later days. I'm gone myself. And actually, this would be a good opportunity to use a Molotov here myself. There we go. Now, I will tell you...
Any more of these fuckers? No.
I will say, they don't normally go up there. That was basically worst case scenario all across the board. But the thing is, I don't really use Molotovs all that much in this DLC. There's another opportunity to later, and I would have rather have kept that, you know, that brick. But that's okay. That's everyone that's in here, and I guess we'll move on. I didn't get touched, so that's a plus. Plus, I don't know. We'll probably go for a brick. That would be a good idea, I think, for this next part. So over here, there's, yes, another arrow. So we have 7, which is really good. And although I kind of feel like I should make another Molotov, I almost think that making another med pack might be best for us, but we'll see. If we can find more supplies, I'll make it worth our while. So let's get out of here. Also, the general lack of disarray in some of these shops, like, you still have clothes for days. There's some, like, store opening ready level just folded clothes over there, and I don't know, no one thought to come in here for some extra supplies. All right, so just a quick scan out here. Something tells me there's probably nothing. Ooh, except for more sugar. Nice. And we'll take that.
So close. I need a way around.
Yep, that is exactly where we started. So, let's go. Hey, we'll grab the brick, and this is going to be pretty important for us. So, ooh, yeah, I forgot there was stuff up here, too. Okay, just to be on the safe side. Since we already have a med kit, I'll just go ahead and make a Molotov. I feel kind of naked with that one, you know. Whew, another opportunity to really give it to them by pitting the enemies against each other. It's very satisfying. But the infected are actually in a room off there to the right. So I'm going to go this way. And the reason why I brought a brick into this room is so that I could switch it out with this bottle. And once, you know, I get them switched out, we'll be fine. But the second we approach...
What was that?
Hey, what'd you guys find outside?
Not a damn thing.
How do we know they're even here?
We walked around this entire place. There's horse tracks leading in, none coming out. They're here.
Maybe they're already dead.
Then I want to see the fucking bodies.
Look out! Infected!
Oh, see two of them. Last one.
Okay, that guy was calling out all the wrong numbers. Holy Jesus. Alright, well, normally, if we were lucky, a single clicker would be left, but I think we're fine. And I'm not worried about ammo, because we're probably not going to even use this pistol.
There. That's it.
Oh, man, that could have certainly been better, but not the worst in the world. When they start spreading out and running away from the battles, that's what makes me the most nervous about everything. Of course, they will not drop a single bullet. Wonderful. All right, well, I think it was probably like, what, 3 clickers and 2 runners or something to that effect that came out of here. And we do want them to be dead, because not only are we able to get enough stuff to build our bomb, but we're almost ready for a second med pack. We just need another little piece of fabric to help us out. Okay, man, I'm excited to use this bomb. It'll be probably one of the best uses of one that you'll find in any game, plus more useless scissors. Perfect. But aside from that, not a whole lot to really loot from this place. There was one more body that I maybe wanted to look at in case, you know, I needed to use more pistol ammo, but that's fine. That is perfectly okay by me. Ooh, hello. More sugar. Hooray. Man, if only I could actually use it effectively. Yeah, I thought someone ran over here, but maybe not. Anyways, we can open this up, and there we go. Some ammo regardless, so this is good, but if everything goes well for this last fight, I'm not going to need to use the pistol. Granted, it rarely ever does, so we'll just have to see how that pans out. More health, nice. And then we've got a full brick. Cause she's a brick. Yeah, nothing else. That's fine. Okay. So, ladies and gentlemen, knock the bow, get yourself... How did you two die from up here? It means a clicker had to come up here, kill one of you while the other one was right next to him, and then kill the second guy. It's absolutely insane. Oh, you should have done like that other guy did and just cheesed it off by me. God. The AI in this game makes little sense. And then in the second game, they are smarter, but they still kind of have that same strain of DNA where they make really questionable decisions. But here we go. Through here, and it's the last fight. That was weird. My flashlight just changed its own batteries. So we're back here to the pharmacy and American Princess. And you'll see there are actually some corpses here. So we're going to take this steadfast very carefully. And I will wait on these for just a second. Okay, so they're trying to break down the door where Joel is being held, and we are going to have to kill a ton of these guys. And now that I think about it, I should have brought a bottle, but that's okay. There's a brick here.
Fucking door!
So I'm going to distract and grab this. Thank you. And now the idea is to get them away from the door, but not so that they'll notice. If you shoot these guys, generally they will try to find you after, and then you can't kill them stealthily anymore. So they see you immediately. Shit. All right, that's fine. That actually was probably better for him to turn around. Okay, one more. Was that good? I didn't get the arrow. Oh shit, that guy's there. Okay, I think we might have lucked out with their spawns. What the? Oh, you went back to that. Did that miss? Wait a minute, I'm confused. Somebody sees me. Oh shoot, there was that guy there. Okay, normally I don't hang out up here without any arrows, but I think I did kill the guy down there. So if I play my cards just right, toss this brick at him. Oh, and he got really mad there for a second. I don't know what he's doing. What are you doing, my friend? You're doing a very odd thing. Here we go. Yeah. I think we got it. Are we good? That is what I want to see. Oh man, that was pretty great actually. So if you get your position blown at any point, Ellie will say something to the effect of like, ah, fuck it, I'm going loud or something, you know. But that's when our bow will start becoming useless, and it's because we're in stealth that we're able to kill them so easily. There's more health over here. That's pretty impressive. So I'm really glad about that, but I go slower. I don't usually hang out by that nook, and that arrow usually doesn't break. So I will take this brick, and we actually have a little bit of a reprieve here in between quote-unquote waves. So we'll head down here, hope that we can get maybe one or two. Arrows are basically going to be useless for us, but I'm glad that we were able to harvest some of them. So grab that one. So that one spawns there every time, and we've got some peaches. Very cool. Okay, now, this is what I'm interested in, is seeing the dudes that died over here. I was hoping that guy would have fallen all the way down here with an arrow caught in his neck or something, but nope, he just stumbled and died. Alright, well, we got 6 arrows back, so that's really good, actually. And one last thing over here, we can grab more explosives. Ooh, that is really nice. So none of this stuff will be here if you just, you know, restart the DLC from the start. So keep that in mind, that we don't need to explore when we first start the game. We're set. Okay, this is where the bomb comes into play. The second we start opening that door, people with rifles will start coming out, and men will flood out from our old nemesis, the Rivers Cafe. So if we put a bomb right here, then that'll be good for us, because it will kill 3 enemies that will otherwise try to flank us from this store side. So I'm very glad that we were able to at least get enough stuff for that. And if not, you get a ton of explosive stuff over there. Can't make another one, but we can make a smoke bomb. So that's good. And the problem about this next section is that we really have to get lucky. And if you mess up, you have to redo this entire section again. Restart encounter begins at the beginning of this whole encounter. So we'll see. And I guess I lied. We do need ammo for this next bit from our pistol. All right, enough talk, more rock.
She's down there by the door. You gotta pin down, go finish her.
You wanna do this?
Okay, so, bomb didn't work last time, so quick little edit so that we could show the cool thing. But the 3 enemies would be killing my ass right about now. There's still one, though. What are you doing? Who are you? Nobody said that you could survive. Okay, well, this is bad. This is very bad, because I am in a tough spot. Go, get, oh, shit. So this is where we get into trouble. I have no bullets and the infected have joined. So a main point of action that I want to find myself going towards are the rifles. This guy's got one, so I'm gonna get him. And oh Jesus, I don't know what I'm doing. I'm sorry, let me just let you finish. Nope, here we go. Alright, just give me your weapon. You died, right? No, you didn't die. You ran. Okay. Well, this is not going according to plan at all. This is actually terrible. Jeez it! Oh, my worst enemy! The Molotov against me. Okay. So. this was a cluster. Not good. Oh, Jesus Christ, dude. Dude, I threw a... Thank you. Thank God. Give me my weapon, man.
If anyone's alive, don't even think about surprising me. You lit up like your friends, you hear me? Yeah? Yeah.
That was really dumb. I really should have just made a beeline for it, but that is it for combat. We are done, and you can see, look at 3 piles of blood here. 4. They died, but clearly they didn't, or maybe more spawned. I don't know, man, but that does it for the current day section for Ellie, and it could have gone worse, but things definitely did not go according to plan. And it'd be nice if, you know, somehow the hunting rifle could have been thrown across the mall for us, but nah. We're good. We're done. We have no reason to be looting anymore. Thank you so much for watching. Let's finish this thing up.
You better be alive, Joel. Don't worry. I've done this before. I'm kind of an expert. Ish. Just stay calm. Stay calm.
There's some more stuff over there you can break.
What are we gonna do?
The way I see it, we got two options. Option one, you take the easy way out. It's quick and painless. I'm not a fan of option one. Two, we fight.
Fight for what? We're gonna turn into one of those things.
There are a million ways we should have died before today. And a million ways we can die before tomorrow. But we fight for every second we get to spend with each other. Whether it's 2 minutes or 2 days, we don't give that up. I don't want to give that up. My vote? Let's just wait it out. You know, we can be all poetic and just lose our minds together.
What's option three?
Sorry.
So with that, ladies and gentlemen, my name is Allison Cruz. Thank you so much for joining me on this walkthrough of The Last of Us Left Behind. It is the last of what I planned on covering for this game, and I think that this DLC ends the project on a high note, because it should come to no surprise, but I am a huge fan of character and plot-driven stories, and like I mentioned before, the voice acting, the story, the overall arc of where this DLC goes and exploring some of the things that happened in the lead up to the main game. I'd really enrich the experience, they enhance it and put emphasis on Ellie, which is great because she is the star of not only this game but the next as well, which I am going to be covering sometime soon. So far I've only played The Last of Us Part 2 once, very thoroughly, but only once, and I'd like to kind of go through it again before really putting pen to paper and figuring out how we're gonna do it, because that game is pretty massive and it's really good. I like it a lot. People will have their opinions on it, and I fully understand that. I'm gonna go in there expecting everybody to absolutely hate it, but I think I can make a pretty good case for why it's good. Oh no, the company mascots, moral boosters, and food patrol? No! Aw, poor doggos. Why do I have to go and do that at the end of this? Man. But, yeah, for as many cutscenes as there were here, I really appreciate the story because I could actually relate to their relationship with somebody I knew growing up who was basically my Riley. And it's pretty sad. If you want to know more about it, we could have a damn good crescendo in this song, but I wrote an album about it. My burst together musical project thing that I did, more or less, is based on that. But this looks like the end, so let's just go ahead and call it here. Thank you so much once again. Sometime in the near future, we're going to be tackling part two, and I hope you guys look forward to it, because it'll probably be a little better than this. So I will leave you guys on a high note. We will have a lovely picture of the two of them, our intrepid protagonists from the concept art. And I will see you here next time for whatever I have next, because I don't know. It's probably going to change. It's probably going to be like 5 months before I even see it. Here we go. Good times. My name's Allison Cruz. Take care, and I'll see you guys next time.